All right. Oh, Dirk, what is that? Yeah, look at it. I think Irish is surprised to see that happening here. So is Das Gregor and all the others. Look at this. I'm in a virtual box here, I must say that. Because I try to start walking with it. As I said, I've seen tons of stuff. I let the cat out of the bag now. This is i3, and that is the i3 config. I'll just keep it short here. So I edited the i3 config file here already with Nano, of course. What else is there? So I have to give you, I want, you know, the bar on the bottom is so wrong. It cannot be. So rule number one and two, Dirk must be right. So the rule number two, if that doesn't seem to be the case, rule number one will be enforced. So I've put in position, and then tap again, and I say top. And I think when I go out here with Control X, save it. Oh, I have to say yes. Then it should pop up to the top. No, it did not. So that file is what I edited. Sudo space nano space /home/dirk/.config/i3/config. I think there's a way you can back it up and just have an i3 config file in your thing. But I haven't looked into that yet. As I said, I'm trying to learn walking here with i3 because there's lots of little things I like. So let me see if I have that here. I went to two, I just opened Thuna to see how it looks like. That's my workspace 2. 3 is Chromium. 4, I think there's that. Number 1 is just a terminal. So I like the way that you can switch around here. That is what has impressed me. So you can go from one workspace to the other just with a keystroke. You bang, you're there, bang, you're there. So it's a little bit more order, and it's 10, and they don't overlap and crowd your workspace so much. So I'm very impressed with it, and that's what I was really keen and to figure that out. Yeah, that didn't work yet. Network browsing, of course, it's Ubuntu, it will work if I go there. But however, yeah, so I hold my mod tast, which is the Windows key, and then 1 is for my first workspace, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, and so on. I can open a 5th one, so you see. But I'm cheating a little bit because I want to learn walking with it, and I need to have some standard routine commands first before I totally get locked out here or whatever. I know with mod and D you can open programs, but I, you know what, I get the heck out of it here, and I go to number 4 first, or number 5, open a new one, and then I could say mod D, and I could call programs, I guess. I'm not calling Thunderbird. Let's say mousepad, I think, should be still installed, because mousepad, yeah, it's there. And I think mod Q, no, it did not. Control Q? Yeah, Control Q is closing stuff. So I believe in the beginning I will use my XFCE programs because I'm used to them, and later I might just change. Because for Suna, a nice replacement could be for me Midnight Commander. That's what I used for quite some time and I like it a lot. I think I have it installed here, so let's try this Windows D and call MC if it is there. Ren. Is it happening? Seems to be a bit slow, actually. I don't know why. Interesting. i3 was supposed to be fast. Maybe it's just searching and can't find it. Maybe I haven't installed Midnight Commander yet. You know what? We can do that. I go in number 6. Oh yeah, I'm in number 6. Oh, it just switched number 5-6. It doesn't give me a real number 6. So what I could do, I open a terminal, which is, I think, Control Enter. Doesn't do anything. Mode key Enter. Yeah, here we go. So I just go sudo apt-install, I think it was. MC. Let's see if that works. Get. Maybe it's just an install. I thought it had. See, that's the problem. If you use so many operating systems. No, it wasn't installed. That's why I couldn't open it. if you use so many operating systems, you can get confused with the commands, right? So Debian Ubuntu base is different to FreeBSD, to Fedora or CentOS or all the others, right? Like Gentoo and stuff like that. So now I have it. So now I could call here. No, I don't do it like this. I want to go number 5. I go number 6. So mod D. And now I say MC. And that should open my Midnight Commander. Dum, 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 dum. Very funny. I thought i3 is fast. Dang-a-ling. I installed it now. Maybe I have to call it Midnight Commander. By the way, sorry guys that I'm... Oh, I typed that wrong. I'm a little bit late because I was doing my driving instructor stuff. I should be done with my practical part in end of February, the way it looks like, because I'm pretty fast and I think I'm not that bad. My senior driving instructor is happy with what I did. Just did some training with some students, then I did my own road test and I passed that too. So I'm looking forward to get that up and running, because then it will be nice. Sadly, I might have to quit another job, which I have, which I like a lot, but I might have to quit it just because I'm still a married man and I would like to stay that way. And even if my wife doesn't believe me much, but I do love her and I want her to be with me. But hey, that's women for you, right? They, I don't know how they tick and how they work. I mean, it's women are just like a book, you know, in a language you don't understand. That's what it is. I wonder if you can search for, if I say midnight and star, do you think it will search for it? Midnight. Let's see. No, it doesn't. No, it doesn't give you options. So that's another thing it looks like. If you're an i3 and you don't know exactly how it is, you're not getting to get it started. So that's a little boomer. So I guess I will hopefully talk better from you guys and say, Jerk, you noob. You just don't know how to do it. Let me know, guys, how I'm going to do this. And there is something how you can... next time when I boot, I'm for sure know that this bar will be on the... Yeah, that panel bar will be on top. And there is a way to start it. I just don't remember. That's why I'm in a cheating mode here. So I'll do that in a virtual box for a moment, just to get the basic controls. And then it goes on hardware. I want to see how it behaves, right? And the way it looks like, I might just put it here on my gaming laptop. The idea is because I'm really fond. Look at this workspace 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I can open more if I want to. So that is very nice to me. So you can have dedicated workspaces. I used it in KDE with, what was it called? It wasn't called workspace. They have workspaces and activities. And I like that too, because Activity gave you a real new, brand new desktop. It was totally different to workspaces, in my opinion. And I must say, I'm intrigued. When I saw how they play around with their windows and window tiles, that is neat. And that's what I want. So I'm traitor! Dirk, you traitor! You want XFCE? Yes, I do like XFCE a lot. And it will stay, XFCE has always a place on my, I mean, I say that now, right? But no, it will always have a place on at least one computer of mine. And it should be maybe my gaming machine where it stays. But I imagine if I do just have a computer, like when I get my driving instructor running, I have to have a computer which is dedicated for that work. I was thinking, you know what, why not put IE3 on it? I might have to put XFCE on it to boot in for accountants or stuff like that, to make it more visible and workable for those people. But I don't know how Irish did this spell here, but it seemed to work. In a moment, I'm looking into it for a long time. Every time when you guys give you guys a hint, the idea was I got into IE3, and I find it a little bit more better than OpenBox. And why would you say that, Dirk? Because OpenBox is still a more graphic environment and gives me the idea it must work like XFCE. But that's my mindset, right? And that's what I have. if I, on the other hand, I have i3, all you have, you see, is that black screen with dots. And that doesn't give you the feeling you must have it like a full-blown graphical environment. And that's a down, not really a downside, but that's the perception I have. And that makes me work different with i3 compared to OpenBox. Even though I think I like OpenBox too, what I've seen in Salient OS, that was a neat setup. I mean, the dock worked fine. Once I got that all set up, I have my main stuff there. It's pretty neat. It's nice. And I saw a video from Irish where he said set that up when he's opening a browser or something like that. It pops up in this window. I think it was Irish. And if you open that, the email client opens up there and stuff like that. And I liked the idea. I really liked the idea of it. And this would be neat. This would be very, very nice to me. And so I'm looking forward to it, actually. And but I need some help, guys. What are the most important basic commands? So I know a little bit how to have a tiled window. So if I open Suna once, let's see. No, I'll do it different. I open Suna here again. Yeah. Oh, let me go. You see, I'm already in Suna. So now I open mode D and I open Suna again. Let's say so. I've got two Sunas open. That should tile it. Grand. So I can shift the focus, I think. Hold on, how did I do it? With the mod key, I can move back and forward. And you see on the right side, I have template underlined. I think if I go shift and mod. No, it didn't. Shift? No. Oh, okay, that's how you mark them. All right. Shift and mod. Oh, yeah, see, I can move it around. When I have my mod key and shift, then I move these windows back and forward to drain. Yeah, so I like the idea. Now Control Q should close this one, and I'm back to a single one. And I don't have to resize the window, because for me then nowadays a workspace will be, I would have tiled windows, which is neat. And there's a way how to move these windows when they're tiled. Hold on, I open another Tuna window just to play around with it. Ran. And I think if you hold shift, and this is just moving it. If I hold Alt and Shift, can I move the corners? There's a way how you can enlarge this, right? If I just do Shift, no, that just moves it inside. Mod Shift, not. Alt Shift, no. Control Shift, no. So there is a way how you can enlarge, and let's say the right Suna compared to the left Suna. But I have no idea how it goes. So I might have to, I need your help, guys. I need to know the basics. I need to know how enlarge windows or make them smaller, you know, a little bit wider. Like if I have a browser, the browser doesn't have to be the full screen. Usually on a 16:9, two-third will do. And then in the other third, you can open something else like HTOP or stuff like that. You know, just little things or little terminal HTOP. So you have a multi-user, still very good workspace. And when the windows are tiled like this, that makes them neat. So I love the idea. So like if I would open, I go to the left now here, go to the left, and I think I go shift and arrow down, or shift, mode and shift and arrow down. Oh, look what it does. Okay. So if I go to the left, I think if you go shift and arrow and open then another window, wasn't it control or mode? Ah, here we go. Now I can go shift, arrow down, and nothing happens. Mode shift, arrow down. Okay, but you see, I want it like that, but small. I want the right side window big and the terminal going to the left side, so that I have two windows on the left and one on the right. But I don't know how to make that window smaller. You know, I can't move it. I'm incapable. So I have to close it. Control quit. Shouldn't that close it? Mode and quit. No, that didn't work. Control quit. So it didn't work. Control quit. Control shift quit. No. Okay. That gets out. Okay, but that was not the way how you close it. Oh, is that the way? Let's see. Control Q. Okay, yeah. I've seen the terminal, you just go out like that. So I quit this one too. Now if I move, I think How do I move? You see, I'm still struggling here, guys. Okay, yeah, with mode. And then the number. That's how I move around here. See, the numbers are wrong in a moment here. It's 1, 2, 3. Oh, yeah, it goes back. It goes back. 5, 4, 3. This should be... There's a 2. Okay, but... So you see, I'm missing the basics. I have to read up and learn a bit. So if you guys, but not just link to the i3 website, I have that already and I have some basics. That's why I can move a little bit here. The major keys, what do you, if you use i3, what's the most you are using and how do you open, let's say if I install Basilisk, how do I get this script to just run if I search for it? Because I know it doesn't do it. See, if I go mood D, and I know I have Basilisk in my folder, but I have no link to it. Basilisk. And it won't find it and it won't fire it up, of course. Because it's just in my app folder. It's not installed properly because Ubuntu doesn't do it. I haven't added it to the menu properly because if I'm i3, I would not have that menu, right? So how am I going to do this? Of course, I could go here, and but I don't want that. I could go here and say apps, and then I go not there. Okay, ls. So I have to see, I would have to go to Oh, my apps folder is not here. That's interesting. Is that because I am on top? Doesn't work either. Oh, it's a color. Downloads. Let's see. LS. Oh, because it's a new desktop. Of course, there's nothing there. So I would have to move everything over. Okay, that's all right. But I doubt that it would search the whole system for my Basilisk browser. So how would you do this in i3? How do you get an application to easily find and start it up, or an app image if you want to? How do you do this? So I hope you guys help me out here, especially the i3 guys. That's a Dirk in distress. Help me out, guys. Let me know. I'm very, very interested in... getting a running in i3, so that would be nice. Sudo command not found. Was I not sudo? Why am I not sudo? Let's try su. Okay, so for some reason, authentication failed. How is that possible? I'm logged in as a Dirk. There is no root password. Sudo doesn't exist. Sudo shut down. Shut down scheduled. Okay, I should have muted it now or something like that. So that should shut down the machine. Yeah, I'm intrigued. I know, guys. How did you get under the spell of Irish? I don't know. This banker has some powers, I tell you that. And I think he worked in conjunction with our tycoon Das Gregor. So, yeah, I think he has his own jet and is traveling through the whole US and doing all this stuff. I think he owns the whole state as his own. So, yeah, quite interesting. All right, so I hope you let me know. Like, how do I exit here? How do I get out of it? Shut down, I think, is the best option I have seen. And... how long will it take me? 1750? So it gives me a minute or something like that, right? Okay, nevertheless, I will get out of this now and watch it hopefully shutting down. And yeah, it did. I think I'll just say shut down now or something like that. That will do it. So you see, it's my Ubuntu because that's my training, my sparing thing. And of course, I would need, I must have a proper background. So all these little setups, ideas and tricks and stuff like that, guys, I need to know. I need to know. And I would love to have that from our community here on this channel. Because we have lots of people doing tons of stuff. And I must say, when I go i3 on hardware, it will be FreeBSD. That's what I'm going to do. It will be FreeBSD. 99% sure. I just want to see it working there. So that would be what I want. Because I think the FreeBSD, that will be my operating system for my let's call it office or business laptop, which I don't have yet. I have to buy one. Woohoo! So to make it work. And no, maybe I just use it on an old computer, but I've got Void running there with XFCE, and that's doing a good, great job. I could also run i3 there if I want to. Yeah, but I don't have a scanner working yet. It seems to be standing still with the scanner. I could work around it having a virtual box and then putting some lightweight in and install hplib properly, like in a Debian based. I could use MX17 or Linux Lite. That would do a brilliant job there too. Maybe I'll go for something like MX17 or something, or Linux Lite. One is a Ubuntu based. So I will have a look. I will see. Because I would only fire it up if I really need something else. Like in my calculated Linux, I wouldn't have any trouble like that. But I want to go a different route just for the playing on it. I mean, my calculated Linux is on my gaming laptop, which is my daily driver. For gaming, that is what you see here. That is my Xubuntu, what I have in a moment. And it gives me some strange errors after updates and stuff. And I haven't had that on Linux Mint, I must say. So when I rearrange my gaming laptop, which hasn't happened yet, it will be that I have Linux Mint running, Cinnamon actually, because that's their baby. I tried XFCE, that doesn't look right to me. So and I would have then their baby running here, the Cinnamon desktop, for my gaming needs, until I figure out how to get the NVIDIA graphic card running on my, maybe with Bumblebee on Calculate Linux. That would be actually the breakthrough for me. Then there would be no need for a different operating system on my gaming laptop. But until then, yeah, I could also put Calculate Linux on this. I have to see. I just, because Calculate Linux is already my daily driver here, usual. I would want to see how FreeBSD is doing with i3. I think I test run that a little bit. But first I have to get Famila, guys. So I need your help. Help, 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 help. Help, help a Dirk. Help a Dirk to get more familiarized and some useful comments. And how do you do this? How do you do some own shortcuts to certain app images or scripts you have? Where do you place them? How do you do this? So I really would like to know. Important. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Maybe, maybe help a Dirk. Okay, guys. Oh, by the way, once I got this driving school running, I do believe that I have, again, more and better time to do my videos. And for some reason, I'm just not running out of ideas. I'm just running out of time in the moment, because I've got two schedules to satisfy. And that is a little bit too much, two independent, different schedules. I will see. I will get around it. There's a certain point of where I have to make decisions, which way to go, and I might have to skip my job I do in a moment and go full driving school, which would be neat. And that's more because of my wife. She needs me every now and then, and especially in the winter time with driving stuff and get her back and forward. And of course, I love her and want her to be with me, so I'm happy to do that. She does not know that, or she doesn't believe it. Either way, I'm in a bad book. But that's how it is. She does not know the channel, so no worries, she will never hear. That's just how, you know, life's curveball. Yeah. But however, so nevertheless, I'm totally, I don't know, guys. I'm fully enthusiastic in looking in i3. And that happened when I saw how their window management works. It's so clean. How can I say this? And it's different. I cannot simulate this with my way of using XFCE. The way I use my XFCE, I'm pretty happy with it. But it's different. It is just different. And I might go a little bit more text-based stuff. Because, you know, guys, we have to find a different email program. And it has to be web dev, so I can have my contacts and calendars integrated. Because Thunderbird goes rogue, and I don't want to follow that way. I don't want to become a victim of Mozilla. So there's lots of little things I have to do and change on the system. And I think if you have i3 on and somebody cracks your computer open, I think there's no operating system, just DOS on it. So pretty good. That gives you an extra layer of security. Having said this, I will encrypt my business computer too. It will be Luke, most likely. But let's see. Let's see with what you guys coming up. What would you base your i3 on? If it has to be easy on resources, I know calculator Linux is pretty good. I must say, I could take calculator Linux the base, you know, and then just put i3 on top of it. But I have to be a little bit more familiar with i3 before I can step over to the bright side of life. So when I'm doing that in a virtual box, you know, I want to play around and do some things, and yeah, that's what I'm going to do. And yeah, so I'm excited with what you're coming back to me, guys. So let me know, and don't be too shocked, man. What did you do, Dirk? I don't know. It's Irish fault. It's his fault that I get i3. And does Gregor? Do not underestimate this man just sitting there, breaking every now and then his webcam, and playing in Linux from scratch. See, it's the same thing with him. He loves his Gentoo and works with Gentoo, and but he gets stuck in a moment on Linux from scratch. And so I want to explore FreeBSD, because I think FreeBSD needs a little bit more attention from people, so that they know, you know what, this is a full-blown operating system. And for people who are coming over, I would definitely recommend GhostBSD, because it's a full-blown operating system with easy to work now. I made some step-by-step guides to get the HP printer scanner running. We have figured out how to put very easily and quick the NVIDIA drivers on with no fail. And that's a full-blown operating system. I haven't checked out yet for playing. I will do that too, because I think I still have it installed. But I will install it anyway here on Voyager on the other computer, because I want to see how it behaves when I play. But I haven't figured out yet how to use Linux stuff on it, because I would have to have Steam on and Steam the Linux version in order to make it work. I don't know if play on BSD or the Windows version of Steam would work nicely, so I have no idea. Would be interesting to see. I'm not the latest gamer of this stuff like that, but some little things I would like to see working. But I'm not there yet. As I said, I would like to test it more for office work, so that it become a daily driver for people who do some productive work on it. If I get it playing, it's a bonus. But I'm not there yet. Anyway, i3, guys, i3, 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 I need help, help, help. What is the best way to operate it? How do you set things up to pop up on certain workspaces? How do you get your own script started? Or do you have to start scripting stuff and put that in? I don't know. You let me know. How do you get something like Basilisk if you download it and unpack it? How do you get this up and running? How do you start it with your modd key? I didn't figure it out. I couldn't get... let me see if I got Midnight Commander here. I usually type MC and push the button, and there it is. See, that didn't happen on i3. Even though I installed it, so it should have happened, it didn't. No idea why not. We will figure it out, guys. Okay. Let me know how you do things and how it works, okay? This is it. Got to call my wife. For some reason, she didn't reply. She might be busy doing something else. I don't know. I have to investigate. Okay, guys, I hope you liked that video. I hope you liked that I took on the i3 challenge, the unspoken challenge. And I'm pretty excited. Guys, I get my driving instructor soon. Woohoo! And then I can torture kids. We have to do that way. No, I'll make some safe drivers, and I will do hopefully a good job there, keeping our streets here safe. Too much deaths, too much wasted life. Really, it shouldn't have happened. However, that's a different story. This is it, guys. I hope you like that video, and let me know what you think about the whole thing, i3, and how do you configure it? How do you make it work? As I said, I need to know the basics. How do I open my own unpacked Basilisk folder? So let me know, guys. I want to know the easy way to operate it, so that it is really just a nice experience. Okay, guys, that's me, and I'm out. I hope you liked that video. Let me know, and I hope to see you soon. Oh, by the way, I had a new reply from some guy who did the Viber stuff from MX17, how to get it running in Debian, and it helped, and that is very nice. If I can hear that that my tutorial or my helping videos actually help people, that is honey in the tea. That feels good. All right, so this is it, guys. I'm out, and I hope to hear from you soon. See you soon. Oh, if somebody really gets to the end here, which operating system would you use for i3? I mean, I said already I want to try FreeBSD, just to poke around. As I said, I started them all. I haven't used them much as daily driver yet. I got GhostBeastie installed right now, and NVidiaGra is installed too. So if you want to go FreeBSD, the easy way, just like I like to do usually, I like to go the easy way. I want to have people done all the heavy lifting for me and get it all up and running. So that's why I use distros. So I don't go Gentoo, I go Calculate Linux, because they have done everything and they have their special scripts which make my life so much easier in Gentoo. And it's a full-blown Gentoo. That's a thing, Irish, you might have to have a look into it. You still have full control. In a few clicks, you're purely back on Gentoo repos, but I would not uncut or take off the Calculate repos, because they are doing a good job. And you have all the scripts and all that stuff. So easy maintenance and still full control in Gentoo. Okay, that was it for you, Irish. For everybody else, what operating system would you use it for? And you know my special needs. I need a printer, I need a scanner, I need to be able to access my network, my local network, internet browsing, email client, some office stuff, screen recorders, and this is it. Games would be perfect. Let me know. This is it. Oh yeah, and I have to throw on here my Synology clients, like here on the bottom drive, you know, and cloud backup. So I want to have this and notes, and they have to work too. Do you guys think Ubuntu would be a good platform to do that? On XFCE, I have lots of crashes when it starts. All the time is something crashing. So that's why I'm not the biggest fan from Ubuntu. So would you go Ubuntu? Would you say rather Debian? I mean, Ubuntu, as I said, that would work on my gaming laptop very nicely. So that would be a plus. I could run it on my gaming laptop and maybe could run my games if I ever figure out how to start these things, right? Let me know. Yeah, maybe that is the thing, because if I have it on my gaming laptop for a while, then I would use it more. That's how I use Calculate Linux usually, you know. I'm usually doing lots of Calculate Linux, but I have to boot for gaming in Ubuntu. That's why you see me often when I record here now in Ubuntu, because I try to take some spare time and play every now and then. Most times, yeah, if you play rigged games like World of Tanks, they're so toxic. Most of the time I just go out Alt+F4 and do something more productive, like installing i3 and making videos for the community, which I really like. I'm very happy. I actually hope the channel is not growing too much, because I like, how can I say this, the social network we have here. It's really neat. I like that a lot. My biggest fear is usual. I don't want to have 10,000 subscribers and then 10,000 people being active. I'm only one person. I can't maintain so much. So I like what I have here on subscribers, and they do their own videos, and I peek in their videos and download them and watch them. And I'm very happy to do this, because I don't want to watch videos like every system gets fired up in a virtual box, or just the live USB stick. The ISO and then, great little distro. How do you know? You haven't even installed it. You haven't even seen the first hurdle. So VirtualBox videos are totally justified if you install it in a VirtualBox. Just firing up the ISO, it's a no-no. That's really not good. So if you install it fully in VirtualBox, that gives you a good idea. So yeah, if you can run it in VirtualBox, you can see how it looks like, how it behaves, stuff like that. And then where the rubber hits the road, that is more than when you install it on a hardware, because then you have to install your AMD driver, Intel driver, you have to install an NVIDIA driver, and other stuff. And then you actually start using it, and then you find maybe pitfalls, because it might do lots of things good, and then all of a sudden you figure out, oh, it's not doing that. So, and then you can work on a solution, hopefully, and make a tutorial and say, yeah, that's easy. We do it that way. But that's just me. That's how Dirk rules the world. I'm not having for nothing my avatar, which the idea came from the Irish. Okay, guys, this is it. I'm out now. I hope you like the video. Let me know what operating system. Is Ubuntu an alternative? Should I do it? Let me know. And yeah. And what do you use when you use i3? What is your file manager? I know Ranger is it is for Irish, and I think Das Gregor uses Ranger too. And he made an extra video how to get some colors in, because colors is good. I like colors. Is Ranger superior to Midnight Commander? How does it behave? How do you get network access with it? Can I just easily double click on something, or put my SMB, you call these columns in, /forward/, and then my IP address. So I don't know. In Midnight Command, I'm a little bit more familiar with Ranger. I have no idea what email program would you be using, or browser. Browser, I still think I stay with Basilisk. I like that a lot. Chromium for translation stuff. Tor browser is a must have nowadays, because everything gets tracked. Everything you do gets tracked. So Tor browser gives you some privacy. Don't believe in this privacy tab, you know, that's a nice little lie. That's how they calm people down. A privacy tab. Yeah, they got ideas, right? Yeah, don't believe in them. And then I need Google Chrome, that's for sure, to upload stuff to Google Play. It did not work for me in Chromium browser, but it did work in Google Chrome with flawlessly. So I need Google Chrome too. This is it. Then I like little things, you know. I like to have my game War Thunder is pure Linux, that is pretty good. Then I've got War Thunder running in Play on Linux here, that is doing a good job. Viber, I use that. I would like to have Handbrake, Gparted, it is pretty good. Edge, the DD command does a really good job too. My simple scan, yes, I like it. In FreeBSD or GhostBSD, I used Gscan to PDF. It does a good job too. Then Converter, that's good, because if I upload stuff to Google Music Play, they wanted an MP3, and I've got lots of WMA formats, so I got to transform them. That's why they're here. These are my usable things, what I use. And VirtualBox, I need that. I've got OpenShot here. I try not to use it, because that would make me work. And Redshift is a must-have. You must have Redshift. Really. Protect your eyes, you need Redshift. So this is it. I think I said that already one time. So not that I repeat me very often here, myself, very often. I cut the video off now, and I'm really interested to see what's coming, guys. I want to see the comments. Let me know, guys. Share your experience and your ideas. What operating system would you use? Because it's different when you use i3. At least I believe that. Let me know. I'm very, very nosy. I would like to know. And I hope you guys share your ideas and just everything about it. Okay, I'm out now, guys. I have to upload it so I know what you guys think. Okay, bye-bye, guys.